Okay, let's talk about PyMongo. Now, PyMongo is one of the MongoDB drivers, or client libraries. And because Python is the programming language for this course, we'll be using the Python driver. You'll find that you have access to PyMongo in the IDE. Now, one thing to keep in mind about PyMongo or any other MongoDB driver is that their basic job is to maintain a connection to the database and to allow you to work in your language of choice and interact with your data in a very natural way. Now, if you'd like to know more about drivers for other languages, I'd encourage you to visit api.mongodb.org, where you can read about all supported drivers. Now, before we dive in and look at an example, I want to talk a little bit about the application architecture, just so you have that picture in your mind as we're working through the rest of the material in this lesson. Okay, so if you download MongoDB and run it on your local computer, this picture basically represents the architecture. You'll start MongoDB, and the daemon that's running is MongoD. And then you'll create a Python application that includes the PyMongo module. And using the PyMongo module, you can send requests and receive responses from MongoDB. PyMongo communicates with the database using what we call the wire protocol. And the data that's exchanged is in a format called BSON. BSON is a binary encoding for JSON. If you Google for BSON, you'll easily find the spec. Okay, so let's look at an app. Okay, here I'm going to use that example that we saw before for the Tesla S, but let's talk about the PyMongo components of this particular application. Here we're importing the Mongo client class from the PyMongo module. And then we're going to create a client object, and note that here we specify the connection string. We won't go into too much detail on this, but essentially this will allow us to connect to any MongoD instance that we have access to. Okay. Here's the encoding of the Tesla as a Python dictionary. And then here what we're doing is specifying that we want to use the examples database. And what we're going to do here is insert this document here. Finally, we're going to do a find query. And then for every document that we get back, we're simply going to print that document out. Okay, now before we run this, I want to point out two things. One is that here we're using the insert command in order to store this document in the autos collection for the examples database. Here we're using the find command, and find, when run this way, will simply give us back a cursor for all of the documents in this case, the autos collection, whatever collection we specify here. Okay, and we'll go into more detail on these later on in this lesson. So let's run this. Okay, and we can see that what we got back and printed out was the one and only document that we had inserted into this collection. Brand new collection. When we inserted the document, that became the first document in the collection. And one thing I want to point out is that in addition to all of the fields we specified in our code, there's a new field, underscore ID, that has this object ID value. Okay, that's a value that was added by the database, and we'll talk a little bit later about exactly what this value represents. The short story is that MongoDB ensures that any document we insert can be uniquely identified by its underscore ID field. And if we don't specify a value for underscore ID, MongoDB will create one for us.